CIET-NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 7.
Hello dear students, this is your friend Premlata. Nice to meet you once again. Hope you are happy, healthy and fine. Today we will study more about fractions, which is chapter 2 of NCERT Maths book of class 7th. In the previous session we discussed what fractions are and what are their types. We had talked about like fraction, unlike fraction, proper fraction, improper fraction, and equivalent fraction. In this session, we will move one step ahead and we will learn about multiplication of fractions. Multiplying fractions is very easy. In fact, it is easier than adding fractions. That is why we are going to learn multiplication of fractions before learning how to add them. I request you to have a pen and a paper to write the examples which we would be discussing. It will help you understand the concepts better. So I hope you are ready with a pen and paper. Let's begin. Now our question is 1/4 times 2/3. That is 1/4 times 2/3. I repeat, 1/4 times 2/3. In order to complete the multiplication, we will multiply numerator of the first fraction with the numerator of the second fraction. Similarly, we will multiply denominator of the first fraction with the denominator of the second fraction. Now tell me, what is the numerator in 1/4? It is 1. And what is the numerator in 2/3? It is 2. So when we multiply these two numerators, we get 1 times 2 equals to 2. Now tell me, what is the denominator in 1/4? It is 4. And what is the denominator in 2/3? It is 3. So we will multiply these denominators and we get 4 times 3, which is equal to 12. So what will be our final answer? When we multiplied the numerators, we got 2. And when we multiplied both the denominators, we got 12. So our resultant fraction would be 2/12. So what do you mean by multiplication of fractions? Well, it means that to multiply fractions, all you have to do is multiply the top numbers of both the fractions and then multiply the bottom numbers of both the fractions. And aha, that's your answer. Let's take some other example. Let's try the problem 2/3 times 4/5. That is 2/3 times 4/5. I repeat, 2/3 times 4/5. Now tell me, what is the numerator in 2/3? It is 2. And what is the numerator in 4/5? It is 4. So when we multiply these two numerators, we get 2 times 4 equals to 8. Now tell me, what is the denominator in 2 by 3? It is 3. And what is the denominator in 4 by 5? It is 5. So we will multiply these denominators. We get 3 times 5, which is equals to 15. So what will be our final answer? When we multiplied the numerators, we got 8. And when we multiplied both the denominators, we got 15. So our resultant fraction would be 8 by 15. So we can say that 2 upon 3 times 4 upon 5 is equal to 8 upon 15. Now time for another problem. This time we will multiply 3 fractions together. What is 1 half times 4 thirds times 3 fifths? Or we can say that 1 by 2 times 4 by 3 times 3 by 5. I repeat the question. 1 by 2 times 4 by 3 times 3 by 5. Now let's do it in baby steps. What is the numerator in 1 by 2? It is 1. What is the numerator in 4 by 3? It is 4. What is the numerator in 3 by 5? It is 3. So what we will be doing is we will multiply all the numerators, which are 1, 4 and 3. What do we get? 1 times 4 times 3 is 12. Now let's look for the denominators. What is the denominator in 1 by 2? It is 2. What is the denominator in 4 by 3? It is 3. And what is the denominator in 3 by 5? It is 5. So now we will quickly multiply all the denominators, which are 2, 3 and 5. What do we get when we do 2 times 3 times 5? Think quickly. Yes, it is 30. Our final numerator which we got was 12. And final denominator which we got after multiplication was 30. So our final answer would be 12 upon 30. And if we simplify it further by dividing both the numerator and the denominator of the fraction by 2, we get 6 upon 15. And if we want to simplify 6 by 15 further, we can divide both the numerator and denominator of 6 by 15 by 3. We will get the answer 2 upon 5. We now see that there is no common factor between 2 and 5. So it cannot be simplified further. Hence, our final answer will be 2 by 5. Remember, there is another way to think about fractions. We can also use fractions to represent parts of things, like half of a cake. For example, does it make sense to multiply half a cake by another half? Actually, it does. If you are thinking of fractions as part of something, then multiplying fractions is really like taking part of another part. For example, there is half of a cake. Now I think that if I take one half of that half cake, what I get is 1/4 of a cake. And if we do the multiplication of half times half, we get 1 by 4. So that's why you can think of multiplying fractions as taking part of another part. In fact, especially in word problems, you will see multiplying fractions is written using the word of instead of the word times. They may say as, what is 2/3 of 3/4? And now you know that they just mean what is 2/3 times 3/4. That is 2 by 3 times 3 by 4. Now what is the numerator in 2 by 3? It is 2. And what is the numerator in 3 by 4? It is 3. So when we multiplied 2 and 3, we got 6. What is the denominator in 2 by 3? Yes, it is 3. And what is the denominator in 3 by 4? Yes, it is 4. So when we multiply 3 and 4, we get 12. So here, the new fraction would be 6 upon 12. And when we simplify it by dividing both the numerator and denominator by 6, we get the final answer as 1 by 2. Now let's talk about division of fractions. But in order to understand how to divide fractions, we first need to learn about something called reciprocal, which is also known as multiplicative inverse. Reciprocal is just fancy math term for what you get when you switch the top and the bottom number of a fraction. That is, the numerator of a fraction will become the denominator and the denominator will become the numerator. For example, if you have the fraction 3 over 4, then switch the top and the bottom number, you will end up with 4 over 3. Or we can say that 4 over 3 is reciprocal of 3 over 4. Let's take another example. Let's say there is a fraction 5 by 7. So what will be the reciprocal of this fraction? Remember, you have to switch the top number and the bottom number with each other. So what will be the reciprocal of 5 by 7? Yes, it would be 7 by 5. One very interesting thing about reciprocal is that when you multiply a fraction with its reciprocal, you will always get 1. That is because you will have the same multiplication problem on the top and the bottom. On simplification of that fraction, we will end up with 1 over 1, which ultimately is called 1. One most important concept which you learnt during this conversation is that 1 is the multiplicative identity, and we get the multiplicative identity if we multiply a fraction with its multiplicative inverse. And the multiplicative inverse is also known as reciprocal. To understand this, let me take an example for you. What is the multiplicative inverse or the reciprocal of 1 by 2? I repeat, what is the multiplicative inverse or the reciprocal of 1 by 2? I'm sure you will say 2 by 1 because we have to switch the top and the bottom numbers. When 1 by 2 is multiplied by 2 by 1, you get the result 2 by 2. And when we simplify 2 by 2, ultimately we get the answer as 1. Now that was interesting. But what does reciprocal have to do with dividing fractions? Well, reciprocal is a really cool trick that makes dividing fractions very easy. Whenever you have to divide something by a fraction, you can just multiply it by the reciprocal of that fraction and you will get the answer. It is a great news because multiplying fractions is so simple that you have learnt it already. The trick of multiplying by the reciprocal works because fractions are really just mini division problems. Multiplication by 1 by 2 is same as dividing by 2. The 2 is below the fraction division line. That is, 2 is the denominator and dividing by 2 is the same as dividing by 2 over 1. Because you can turn any number into a fraction by just writing a 1 as a bottom number. Is that correct? I repeat once again that multiplying by 1 by 2 is the same as dividing by 2 over 1. So, you have found out that you will never have to divide fractions. You can just rewrite your division problems so that you are multiplying by the reciprocal of the fraction instead. Then, when you multiply, you will get the answer for the original division problem, like we always do. Let's take some more examples to understand this once again. Let's try this problem. 3 by 4 divided by 2 by 7. I repeat, 3 by 4 divided by 2 by 7. So now, the first thing we want to do is rewrite our problems by writing the reciprocal of the second fraction. Instead of dividing 2 upon 7, we can multiply by the reciprocal instead. The reciprocal of 2 by 7 is 7 by 2. So our problem now becomes 3 by 4 times 7 by 2. Oh, I should mention a mistake that a lot of students make when they first learn to divide fractions. Sometimes the students take the reciprocal of the first fraction, the one that is being divided. Sometimes some students even do the reciprocal of both the fractions. Both of these strategies are wrong. But just remember that you have to take the reciprocal of the second fraction only. That is the one you are dividing by. Okay, now that a problem has been changed to multiplication, it is super duper easy. Now let me remind you what the question was. It was 3 by 4 divided by 2 by 7. So here you have to multiply 3 by 4 and 7 by 2. Now what is the numerator in 3 by 4? It is 3. What is the numerator in 7 by 2? It is 7. So when you multiply both the numerators, that is 3 times 7, you get 21. Now what is the denominator of 3 by 4? It is 4. And what is the denominator of 7 by 2? It is 2. So when you multiply 4 and 2, you get 8. So the answer or the resultant fraction is 21 upon 8. Isn't that easy? Let's take one more example. Let's try this problem. 5 by 6 divided by 9 by 2. I repeat, 5 over 6 divided by 9 over 2. So now, first thing we want to do is rewrite our problem instead of dividing 5 over 6 by 9 over 2, we can multiply by the reciprocal instead. The reciprocal of 9 by 2 is 2 by 9. So our problem now becomes 5 by 6 times 2 by 9. I repeat, 5 by 6 times 2 by 9. Now what is the numerator in 5 by 6? It is 5. And what is the numerator in 2 by 9? It is 2. So when you multiply both the numerators, that is 5 times 2, you get 10. Now what is the denominator of 5 by 6? It is 6. And what is the denominator of 2 by 9? It is 9. So when you multiply 6 and 9, you get 54. So the answer or the resultant fraction is 10 upon 54. We can simplify 10 upon 54 as 5 upon 27, as we divided both the numerator and the denominator of 10 by 54 by 2. What is 10 divided by 2? It is 5. And what is 54 divided by 2? It is 27. So on simplification of the fraction, 10 upon 54, by dividing both the top number and the bottom number by 2, we get 5 by 27. Okay, so what sounded really hard at first turned out to be an easy problem. You just have to flip the fraction upside down and multiply with each other, and this is nothing but the division of two fractions. So if you can multiply fractions, then you can easily divide fractions also. You have to remember the golden rule. Just do not forget to flip the fraction by which you are dividing. That is, remember to do the reciprocal of the second fraction. You do not have to change the first fraction at all. And then simply follow the steps of multiplication of fractions. Let's revise what we did today. Multiplication of fraction means that to multiply fractions, all you have to do is to multiply the top numbers of both the fractions and then multiply the bottom numbers of both the fractions. And aha, that's your answer. Secondly, whenever you have to divide something by a fraction, you can just multiply it by the reciprocal of that fraction. You will get the answer. Thirdly, we learned that when we multiply a fraction with its reciprocal, we get the answer 1. 1 is also called the multiplicative identity. Now, since we have learnt a new concept, we must practice it to ensure that we have mastered it. Let me give you some questions for you to do at home. You may write them down on a paper. What is the reciprocal of 7 by 8? I repeat, what is the reciprocal of 7 by 8? I am giving you few seconds for that. Remember, you have to switch the top number with the bottom number, and that is, we have to make the numerator as denominator and the denominator as the numerator. So if your answer is 8 by 7, then you are correct. Now my second question. What is the multiplicative inverse of 3? I repeat, what is the multiplicative inverse of 3. I am giving you few seconds for that. You all know, when we are not provided with the denominator, then by default, we have to think that the denominator is always 1. So I hope your reciprocal of 3 is 1 by 3. Now let's go move on to our third question. Think and ponder. Is multiplicative inverse of 0 possible? Think in that way. Can you divide any number in 0 parts? Just think. No, it is not possible. So 0 can never come in the denominator. Hence, we can say that 1 by 0 or 2 by 0 cannot exist. Now our next question. What is 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2? I repeat, what is 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2? I am giving you few seconds to think for that. I am giving you a hint. When you divide a number by itself, what do you get? So what is your answer? Think. The answer is 1. Now let me give you one last question. What is 3 by 5 divided by 7 by 5? I repeat, what is 3 by 5 divided by 7 by 5? I'm giving you few seconds to write and think. I hope you must have multiplied 3 by 5 by 5 by 7. That is the reciprocal of 7 by 5. And on solving, you must have got 3 by 7. Just remember, whenever you have to divide something by a fraction, you can just multiply it by the reciprocal of that fraction instead, and you will get the answer. I hope you enjoyed the session, refreshed your concepts, and learnt some new things. Thank you for being a good listener. Hope to talk to you again. Bye-bye and have a nice day.
You were just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.